Back 40 Lodge is where our seasonal employees that we hire in the summertime to work on our long trail patrol and as caretakers stay when they're not working in the woods. It's their days off housing. There's some little cabins here where they sleep, and then there's a main building, and the main building is the utility building where we have kitchens and showers and living room and place for them to do their laundry. And so this is another part of our operations that consumes energy, electricity and propane primarily. And so this project that you see behind us, which we refer to as the BioBox project, is sort of the next stage in our effort to become 100% renewable on our energy sources here at the Green Mountain Club. So this unit behind me, we call it a BioBox. And what it is it's a wood boiler, the same kind of wood boiler we have up in the main visitor center, but it is housed in an independent building because we didn't have room in the basement of the Back 40 Lodge to contain the boiler and the hot water storage tanks. So this BioBox, it's a concept from Europe originally, the idea of a self-contained high-efficiency wood heating unit in its own structure. And it's an 8x20 shipping container. And the shipping container was slightly used, so we got it at a good price. And then the company we worked with, Sunwood Systems, fabricated the entire setup at their shop. So they did all the electrical, all the plumbing, they installed the boiler, the chimney, and then integrated insulated hot water storage tanks right into the end of the BioBox unit. And so all they had to do is, once that was done, is bring the BioBox here on a flatbed and then lower it into position with a crane and then use underground piping to bring in the electricity and the supply and return lines to our existing heating system. And so what this allows us to do now is to use cordwood, sustainably harvested from GMC lands, just like our main visitor center, to provide all the heat and hot water for this building. Now this building is not used in the winter, but we don't allow it to freeze completely, so we do provide a small amount of heat to the building, so the wood boiler will be able to do that quite easily. But in the summertime, we use quite a bit of propane for showering and laundry and cleaning up in general. And so that's where this is really going to save us on our energy and help us be more renewable, is that we can replace now a bulk of our propane use with wood energy. So it's going to be the hot water for showers, hot water for washing dishes, hot water for laundry, and then also a very innovative component of all this is a dryer that can run off of the hot water heat rather than using propane to dry clothes. Well, the total cost of the project when it's all said and done will be a little over $70,000. And we received this, the majority of this funding came to us from a grant from Senator Patrick Leahy and working through the USDA Forest Service and the Vermont Department of Forest, Parks, and Recreation. What we looked with the BioBox project out at the Back 40 was actually phase two of this overall grant that we got from Senator Patrick Leahy for biomass upgrades to the Green Mountain Club. So this was phase one, and phase one was adding an additional 1,000-gallon hot water storage tank over here, plumbed into the existing boiler system. So now we have 2,000 gallons of hot water storage, and we needed to add additional storage because we were finding that on the cold winter nights, the heart of winter, and over the weekends when we're not here to operate the boiler and put wood in it, that the single 1,000-gallon tank was getting depleted of its energy prior to staff returning and being able to build a fire. And that meant that the propane system was kicking on. Right, we brought our solar online back in the summer of 2009, and that started out originally with a 2 kW or 2,000 kilowatt hour a year roof mounted array. And then we expanded that to three standalone solar trackers from All Earth Renewables in Williston. And that was able to get us up to about 20,000 kilowatt hours a year of power from our solar. But that was not nearly enough to cover our total demand, which fluctuates between anywhere from 34 to 37,000 kilowatt hours a year. And so what we've been working on since then was how to find a way to get additional solar trackers, because we were fortunate working with All Earth Renewables. They had a program available called a power purchase agreement, which allows us to lease these solar trackers. It allows us to get into this technology at a very low cost more quickly than we ever would have been able to. And so we were fortunate that this time around to work with the Rivendell Foundation, which is from Jeffersonville, to help us provide the funding necessary to do the down payment on four additional trackers. Now, each of these trackers is rated to produce 4,500 kilowatt hours per year. But the beauty of the all-earth renewable all-sun tracker, which these units are, is that they produce about 40% more power than a standalone or fixed array, because they use a GPS unit to track the sun throughout the year. So it's always pointing at where the sun is to maximize the power potential. So the reality is these can produce more like 6,000 kilowatt hours per year per panel. And so what we're looking at is a total of being able to generate well over 40,000 kilowatt hours a year, which is in excess of what we use. These trackers, we're not feeding these into batteries. We are feeding the power back into the grid, but working with our utility, Green Mountain Power, they record the amount of electricity that we generate, and then that gets matched against the electricity we use. And so there'll be periods of time, particularly in the summer months, where we'll generate, when it's sunniest, we'll generate much more power than we're consuming. But that power then gets banked on file to be applied towards our bill during the winter time. And the idea that we're netting out, we're becoming net zero as far as the amount of electricity we're consuming from the grid.